Okay, this is a little different. Let's see, we're going to start. This is a 3D sketch. We're going to start by selecting a plane. You know, if we just start like this, we only got 3D sketch. But if you start by selecting a plane, you can go 3D sketch on plane to start with. I draw a construction line. I got the midpoint selected. So, make coincident. Okay. Damn. Oh shit. Okay. I really think it's silly doing things this way. But I wanted to show you something here real quick. Remember how you can draw a line by inferencing? I know these need to be 75 long. You know, normally I would have just drawn it like this. Goddamn dialogue boxes that pop up every time you blow your nose or wipe your ass. Okay, we're gonna draw a fucking goddamn tangent arc between this point and this point and this point and okay. Guess it doesn't understand what the point of a tangent arc is. Fucking piece of shit. No, it doesn't. It doesn't get it. Fucking piece of goddamn crap. I have to restart the command all the fucking time to get it to work right. That's how great these fucking programmers were. Okay, I'm gonna go highlight that. Hit plane. The distance to 40. Okay. I don't know why we're doing this with 3D. As opposed to just multiple 2D sketches, but because it's all going to be part of a single 3D sketch, I suppose. Okay, you know, I created the other plane, they had me double click off of it and click on the top plane, but you know, really, you just have to edit it that way. But they did show another way of selecting the plane, which is, you know, to click here and then go to the property manager, which is pretty weird. So, but whatever. Anyway, okay, now I guess I'm going to have to do this normal view. I'm going to draw a circle. Yeah, it's difficult to select it otherwise. Oh, son of a bitch. Okay, now I'm going to create another plane based on the right plane, and I guess that's where I want it. So, try this again. I probably had an offset value. I just want to make it coincident with it. Okay. And that's where I want my plane. Okay. Come on, god damn it. Okay. Center line is right through the middle of that motherfucker. Okay, let's, I don't know. Select this fucking plane. I don't know why I'm chasing my tail on this. Okay, make this coincident that I'm going to draw a fucking construction line. Through that. Okay, then we're going to go in our spline and draw like a 2-point line. Seriously? You fucking motherfucker! Unbelievable. Okay. And I'm gonna draw some... construction lines, the vertical, and inference. So we basically have this. Okay, and then just like I suspected, the method of the madness is select one of these, select that control line. Add a tangency. Whoa. Ah, you gotta be shitting me. Fuck. Okay. Any fucking day, you fucking piece of shit. God, I hate how they get stuck in that fucking dumbass smart dimension mode all the goddamn time. Okay, well, you know, this is really goddamn annoying. I can't see shit with this goddamn thing in my way. Yeah, it just shrinks everything. Fuck. God damn it. This fucking goddamn thing is just unbelievable. I can do it this way. Oh, shit. Nope. Oh, it's overdefined. Because the programmers that made this thing are a bunch of fucking assholes. Well, the problem is there was a little goddamn gap there with all these fucking grids and shit. I couldn't see it. This line wasn't actually connected to it. Yeah, now it's not got a problem. Alright, I'm gonna do the same thing here, supposedly. Another 2-point spline there. Put these other motherfuckers in there. Control select. Tangent. Okay. Looks clear. Now let's select this one and this one. Make them tangent too. Alright. And that's groovy. Okay, now I'm gonna exit the sketch. I'm gonna clear some of this shit up. Go hide planes. Although that doesn't really do any goddamn good. So how the hell do I hide these goddamn things? Okay, I think I had to go into, I don't know, top plane. Nope. So what is that damn thing visible? Okay. Oh, great. Let me just go edit the goddamn sketch. If I'm going to property manager and delete them. So I guess that's something to keep in mind, though. You know, you get that property manager that has any planes you create in it, 3D planes, when you're in a 3D sketch. And so now that we stopped out, you know, that hides them, but they're there, but you probably wouldn't be aware of it, because I never even knew that had any functionality outside of, you know, an active command. So that's a nice place to hide it. Okay, now we're going to do a lofted surface. Remember to click roughly. You know, that command manager thing's popping up. That's quick. Well, let's see. Okay. Now this. Go. Alright. I guess I got lucky on the selection point there. Now guide curves. I think we need to select that as a guide curve. That as a guide curve. And that as a guide curve. Okay, and since the lines have been L tangent, I don't know. Let's see, it's got a profile, guide curves. It's probably good enough. Okay, so I created our part. Strange sketch is still visible. Where the hell is the sketch? Oh, piece of shit. Alright, I can hide it now. Alright, so there's a 3D surface created. And that'd be it.